Hello friend, namaste. First of all, I will request all my viewers to please subscribe my channel so that they can see easily the latest videos on the applied maths. Okay friends, in last video we have discussed the transformation of the complex function from one plane to another plane. In the last video we have discussed the transformation of the z plane into the w plane. Okay, we have already discussed. Today our focus is that if that two planes are in such relation w is equal to 1 upon z, it means that if that two planes, w plane and z plane, are in inverse relation, then what will be geometrical interpretation there and what will be the nature of the geometry there, and we will analyze that geometrical interpretation here and we will try to solve one numerical problem to understand the importance of inverse and reflection. Okay, let us start. Let us consider a z. Z is a complex function, we everybody know, which depend upon the two variables, a real variable and imaginary variable. So z is the function of x, iota y, we already know, and we can I have already discussed in the last diagram, in last video, about the argon diagram, in which I have already discussed how we geometrically represent the complex function in the argon diagram. Today our focus is that how that function can be correlate to the another plane if they are in the inverse relation. Okay, let's suppose z is equal to fx, iota y. This is the complex function is the given, and we also know that if there is a relation between the w and z such that w is equal to fz is equal to u plus iota v, if this relation is provided, then we can easily do the mapping and transformation. This is also has been discussed in the last video. Today our focus is to discuss the inverse relation between the two planes, w plane and z plane. So if w is equal to 1 upon z, then first we will discuss the geometrical interpretation. So in order to discuss the geometrical interpretation, we consider here z is equal to re power iota theta. This is the polar form. This is the polar form, which means the polar coordinate p is equal to r comma theta. Polar coordinate means that if there is any point on the curve which have some distance from the origin, and that line joining the origin and the point making some angle with the positive x axis, which is the theta, that we represent in the polar form. The distance from the point and angle that line will make with the x axis, that is r comma theta. So here we are representing that two planes in the form of polar coordinates. So if we first represent z, which is the original complex function, in the form of the polar coordinate, which is z is equal to r e power iota theta, and second will be w is equal to r e power iota phi. Okay, so theta is the rotating angle of the line joining the origin and that point, and phi is the rotating angle of line joining the origin and that point in the w plane, and theta is the angle in the z plane. Okay, and r and pk, small r and pk, are corresponding distance of the point p and p dash from the corresponding origin of the x, y axis and u, v axis of the w plane and x, y axis of the z plane. Okay, so if we compare both relation and we apply z is equal to r e power iota theta and w is equal to big r e power iota phi, w is equal to 1 upon z, and we compare both relation, then we get r is equal to big r is equal to 1 upon r and phi is equal to minus theta. This is very important relation. This relation say that there is a inverse relation in the polar radius and there is a reflection relation in the rotating angle. And here I am representing both thing in this diagram. In this diagram I have considered x, y axis, which is the real and imaginary, and u, v axis, which is again real and imaginary, corresponding to the z plane and w plane. Both diagram are drawn on the same scale in the same plane. Okay, so that I can represent it better. So I have drawn a circle, and on that circle I will consider two points. One point for the z plane, another point for the w plane. So if I consider p r comma theta, which is for the z plane, and here I have, when analyzed and when I have compared, I got big r is equal to 1 upon r. It means that if the same circle can be drawn on the w plane, then its polar radius will be the inverse of the that circle which will will be drawn on the z plane. That is the relation between the polar radius. That we can see here that if the P point is on the z plane and P dash on the W plane, then what will be the relation between the polar radius? Polar radius will vary in the inverse nature. And what will be the variation in the angle? Angle will be differ by negative sign. Theta will be differ by minus theta in the W plane. And it can be also understood from the differ in the angle that there will be some reflection on the x-axis. There will be some reflection on the x-axis, real x-axis. Okay, so if there will be any point on the z plane, okay, and if there is a relation W is equal to 1 upon z, then that point will have reflection of the x-axis on the W plane. Okay, because if this is a z plane, this is the W plane, then here we can clearly see that this is a mirror. If this is the mirror, then we can say that P dash is the reflection of the P. We can say that if this is the mirror, then the P dash is the reflection of the P. This is the geometrical property achievable when we see that if there is relation W is equal to 1 upon z, then transformation in the such manner that x-axis, positive x-axis act like the mirror. Okay, so this is the geometrical property which say that polar radius become the inverse of that which is of the z plane to W plane, and rotating angle is replaced by the negative sign, and geometrical property say that positive x-axis act like the mirror and point as the mirror image of the z plane to W plane, just like the mirror. So we can say here that theta is replaced or differed by the negative sign. This is the geometrical property where W and Z are such that they are related. W is equal to 1 upon Z. So here I am considering an example. Let's suppose we have given an infinite strip which are in such dimension Y is greater than 0 and less than half. If we have infinite strip of such dimension Y is greater than 0, less than half, if this relation I apply for the W is equal to 1 upon Z, then what properties I will achieve on the infinite strip and what transformation I will see on the infinite strip? Let's see. So I know what is the relation W is equal to FZ, of what manner? Inverse manner. So W is equal to 1 upon Z, so I can write W is equal to 1 upon Z. I know that Z is the complex function, so Z will be equal to x plus iota y. So when I will apply or when I will do the or when I will multiply by x minus iota y divided by x minus iota y, then I will find x minus iota y divided by x square plus y square. Okay, so I can here also separate the real variable and imaginary variable, then I will get x upon x square plus y square and minus y upon x square plus y square for the imaginary variable. Or when I will compare this with the W plane which have the u and v axis which is in the form of u plus iota v, then I will get u is equal to x upon x square plus v square and v is equal to minus y upon x square plus v square. And when I will solve this whole equation, then I will get y is equal to minus v upon u square plus v square. Now it is given that y is greater than 0 and less than half. So I will apply both conditions. When y is equal to 0, then I will get v is equal to 0. This is the, let's suppose this is the u which is for the real axis and v which is for the imaginary axis for the W plane. Then v is equal to 0, this line represents the image of the finite strip. Okay, when I apply y is equal to 0, let's suppose I apply y less than half. When I apply y less than half, then I will put here half. When I put here half, then I will get this equation of the circle which is greater than 1, which means that a circle which have center minus 1 should have region of the outside. This is tell that this is a circle have the center 0 comma minus 1, because circle have the equation x minus x1 square plus y minus y1 square is equal to r square, the standard or general form of equation of the circle where x1 and y1 are the corresponding centers and R is the corresponding radius. So I can see here that y1 is equal to minus 1, so center will be 0, comma minus 1. If it, this is the greater than 1, then region will be, or image will be outer region of the circle. So outer region is this. So this outer region and line B is equal to 0 will be image of this strip, infinite strip, under the relation W is equal to 1 upon Z. I am again explaining that if you have to find the image of any infinite strip under the relation, inverse relation W is equal to 1 upon Z, then what you have to do? You have to just apply this relation on W is equal to 1 upon Z, and once you get the relation of U and V in the term of X and Y, then just satisfy the values. So I have satisfied Y is equal to 0 and Y is equal to half. For Y is equal to 0, I get V is equal to 0, and for Y less than half, I get the equation of circle which should have the relation, or I can say which should have the radius greater than 1. And if a circle has a center 0, minus 1 and should have the radius greater than 1, which means that the circle region should be considered of the all the outside. So this will be the center region, and the equation V is equal to 0, which is the constant equation. V is equal to 0 to this line, and outer centered region of the circle will be the image of this infinite strip. So friends, today we have discussed the inversion and reflection, which means that if we have the two planes and if we think about the transformation of that two plane considering the complex variables, then what we have to do, or what should we get in the mind, that there will be two properties associated there. One property is that polar radius will be inverse, and second property is that points on W plane should be called as reflection of that reflection of the point of the Z plane. That's why it is also called the reflection transformation, because second point of W plane is just the mirror image of the point related to the Z plane. Therefore, this P' point is the mirror image along the mirror OX, means the real axis. This is the mirror. This is the mirror image. P' point is just the mirror image, because rotating angle differed by the negative sign. So friends, I hope you have enjoyed this video, and I hope just I am doing some good thing here, and I will try to do some more best things on the upcoming videos. So thank you for listening this video and giving your precious time, and I will request to subscribe my channel to see the latest updates on the applied maths. Thank you friends, and again namaste. Thank you very much.